Listening Library presents The Snatcher of Raven Hollow, Monsterious, Book 2, by Matt McMann. Read for you by Cassandra Morris. Prologue. The creature slipped through the moonlit forest like a wraith. Swiveling its shaggy head, it searched the thick foliage with glowing green eyes. When an imposing rock wall barred its path, the creature paused, peering into the gloom. At the base of the cliff stood a black opening like the mouth of a giant snake. Raising its beak-like muzzle, the creature sniffed the humid night air. Moments later, it stooped and entered the cave, moving easily through a dark, twisting passageway. Rounding a final bend, it emerged into an expansive chamber. Silvery moonlight poured through a gap overhead, casting the creature's eerie shadow against a wall. Stalactites hung from the ceiling like giant stone bats. Pale crayfish darted through the chill water pooled in depressions in the floor. The creature ran a hand over a rough stone ledge, the scrape of its claws cutting the silence. It gazed around the chamber with a low growl of satisfaction. Yes, this would do nicely. Chapter 1. Hey, check that out, Teo said. Logan looked down the sidewalk, squinting in the blinding summer sun. Outwardly, Logan and Teo were opposites. He was short and stocky, with blonde surfer boy hair and pale skin, while Teo was tall and willowy, with brown skin and short ink-black hair. They'd been best friends since the third grade, when she'd stopped Robbie Thomas from sticking Logan's head through the monkey bars. Again. What is it? He asked, shielding his eyes. I think it's a stroller, she said. How did a stroller end up on the side of the road? Oh, maybe there's a baby inside. Logan sighed. Teo always hoped for things to be more exciting than they actually were. In their small town of Raven Hollow, she was usually disappointed. Right, he said. I'm sure someone just abandoned their baby. They walked over to the stroller. It was empty. It probably fell off a truck when someone was moving, Logan said. Or maybe they threw it away on purpose, Teo said mysteriously. Why toss it? This looks almost new. She chewed her lip. I guess. Hey, there's a name on it. Dankworth. She scrunched up her nose as she pulled out her phone and began typing. Sounds like the smell of a swampy butt diaper. A few moments later, she looked up. Got it. Got what? An address. Only one Dankworth in town. It's not far. Maybe we should return this. But what about the pool? Logan whined. It was sweltering, and he'd already put on sunscreen to keep from turning into Lobster Boy. Their plan to swim at the community center sounded a lot better than pushing a random stroller across town. Come on, Logan, it'll be an adventure. He rolled his eyes. What could possibly be adventurous about an empty stroller? Chapter 2. The Dankworth's house was small but well-kept, though the front lawn was overgrown and full of dandelions. Logan stayed with the stroller beside the porch steps, while Teo knocked on the front door. It opened abruptly. A young man with bags under his eyes and a short, ragged-looking beard stood in the doorway. What do you want? He demanded. Mr. Dankworth? Teo said. Her normal confidence was shaken by the man's harsh tone. We, found your stroller and just wanted to bring it back. He looked confused for a moment, before glancing past her to where Logan stood with the stroller. Logan gave an awkward wave. Mr. Dankworth didn't look irritated anymore. He looked angry. Without another word, he slammed the door in Teo's face. She raised an eyebrow at Logan. "That was weird," he said. She walked down the steps. "And super rude. Think we should leave it? I may have picked up on an I don't want it vibe. Observant of you." The door opened again, and a young woman stepped onto the porch, closing the door softly behind her. She was pale and looked like she hadn't slept in a week. "I'm sorry, kids. My husband, he's having a difficult time. We both are." The woman noticed the stroller. Then she put her face in her hands and began to sob. Teo looked at Logan, her eyes wide. He shifted uncomfortably. He never knew what to do when people cried, especially grown-ups. "Are you okay?" he asked, then winced. "Obviously not, Sherlock." "Sorry," the woman sniffed, wiping her face with her sleeve. "I didn't mean to fall apart on you. Been doing that a lot lately." "Do you need help?" Teo asked tentatively. Mrs. Dankworth's lip trembled, and Logan felt his stomach clench. He was afraid she was about to start crying again. "You can't help," she said. "It's our baby. She was stolen." Chapter 3. Logan stared at Mrs. Dankworth in stunned confusion. "Stolen? What do you mean?"
"Our daughter Ellie was taken from our nursery," she said.
"That's terrible," Teo said. "But I'm sure the police will find her." The woman shook her head.
"They don't have any leads. No call for ransom, nothing. She just vanished one night."
Mrs. Dankworth glanced at the stroller, then looked quickly away.
"The stroller was too painful a reminder."
"So that's why you left it on the side of the road?" Logan asked.
"It was rattling in the back of our van when I was driving, making me think of Ellie. I couldn't take it anymore, so I stopped and threw it out."
Teo hesitated before saying, almost apologetically, "Technically, that's littering." Logan cringed. Sometimes that girl just couldn't help herself. Mrs. Dankworth gave Teo a long, blank stare. Finally, she climbed the porch steps and said,
"Thanks for being thoughtful, but please, take it away."
"We're really sorry," Logan began, but the woman closed the door behind her. As he stared at the house, a chill seeped into his stomach. "Wow. That is seriously awful," Teo said. "And strange. I mean, who steals a baby? So what do we do with the stroller? It's too nice to trash it." "My cousin Gabby is still a baby. Maybe my Aunt Rosalyn can use it." Logan called his aunt, but she didn't need one and suggested they donate it to the thrift store. They walked to Crawley Street and left the stroller at the drop-off door behind the shop. Eager to escape the heat, they wandered inside, skimming used paperbacks and looking at peculiar paintings. Teo caught Logan sniffing a book. One of her eyebrows arched so high, it disappeared behind her bangs. "What?" he asked. "I like the smell of old books." She turned away, muttering, "You are so weird." When they walked outside, Teo grabbed Logan's arm and pointed. In the store window was a flyer with the photo of a baby. The caption said the child was missing and pleaded for information. "Sound familiar?" Teo asked. "But the last name's not Dankworth," Logan said. "It's a different family. So there are two missing babies in town?" A shiver ran through him as he thought of his 7-year-old sister Meg. Hardly a baby, but still. What's going on?
I don't know, Teo said with a determined gleam in her eye.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.